Hello and welcome everybody. My name is Mary Shores and I am here today with Cheryl Miur. Say hello, Cheryl.
Hi everyone.
So we are here today to talk about podcasting and I am so super excited because this is the recent brainchild we had to bring everyone a 5-day podcast challenge. But before we get talking about that, let me just tell you that in case you don't know me or we've never met before, my name is Mary Shores, and I am the best-selling author of Conscious Communications, your step-by-step guide to harnessing the power of your words to change your mind, your choices, and your life. And I can teach these things because I truly believe, and it's backed by science, that you can change your reality with just your words. Very recently, like since the beginning of the year, I've just been super pumped to share my passion project, which has been teaching other people to do exactly what I am able to do. One of the ways I've been able to become a best-selling author is by going on tons of podcasts. As a matter of fact, I've been on a, you know what, guys, there is a post-it note that is like bugging the snot out of me. Let me just get rid of that. So I've been on over 120 podcasts and some of them are quite large. And so when I add up the audiences of all of those different podcasts, it has exploded my reach. It's brought me tons of fans. It's built my platform and it's made me such a stronger public speaker. So I just want to hand it over to Cheryl for just a moment so that she can say hello and say a word about herself.
Yeah, absolutely. Thank you, Mary. So if you've never met me before, I am Cheryl Miur. As you can probably tell from my accent, I'm based in England, in the north of England, in fact, in a beautiful area called the Lake District. So lots of lakes, mountains, and probably more sheep than people. So in a former life, when I was living back in Vancouver, I was working in corporate PR. And I was helping multinationals win media coverage in places like the Wall Street Journal, the Globe and Mail, and the BBC. And what I do now is I'm a media strategist for authors. So I help them get published. And some of my wins have been in Forbes and Inc., MindBodyGreen. So think about those really big online outlets. And we do some mainstream stuff for TV and magazines as well. So if that sounds like something that you need, then listen up, because Mary and I have got some really juicy tips for you.
Yeah, we sure do, Cheryl. And thank you. Thank you so much for saying hello to everyone. So we are going to talk today about having a 5-day podcast challenge. And I am so excited about this because, you know, again, being on a podcast, being on a show, it's a great way to, you know, it's a powerful way to share your message. And in a lot of ways, it's easier than just writing a blog post or trying to get booked on a television show because there are so many podcasts. Now, I just want to give a shout out to all of the people who recently attended the Aspiring Authors online workshop. And we've got a special offer for you today that is very exciting and tied specifically to this podcast challenge. And so I'm saying hello to all of the people who were on the Aspiring Authors online workshop. And also some of you have already signed up for our next course, which is the Content Creation and Marketing course. Now, you know, this ties in with podcasting. It's sort of part of content creation because believe it or not, you can create a lot of reverse engineered blogs out of the things that you talk about on podcasts. So without further, go ahead, Cheryl.
Yeah, no, it's so interesting you said that because I know we didn't plan for you to talk about that, but I actually posted something about that on social media yesterday on Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, all over the place about duplicating your content. So one thing you can do is if you do a podcast, take those same messages and put it in a blog post. If you do a Facebook Live, guess what I'm going to do after this? I'm going to export the video and I'm going to upload it to YouTube. So you really multi-purpose your content. And because we talk about content creation and people think it's so much hard work, and in actual fact, all you're doing is putting the same message in different packages, if you will. And you can do that through a number of different ways. Like I said, exporting your Facebook Live, uploading to YouTube, using your podcast as a blog, lots of different ways that you can do it, because people are not as close to our content as we are. And so we assume everyone's heard that podcast interview, so I can't possibly talk about the same thing, but you can absolutely do that and repurpose your content.
Yeah, agreed. And there's lots of places that you can do that. So one of the things that people are always asking me is, Mary, how do you get yourself on all of these podcasts? And believe it or not, I didn't, when I very first started, I've been going on them for about a year. And just yesterday, I was on a podcast called EO Fire, which stands for Entrepreneurs on Fire. It is one of the top podcasts in the entire world. John Lee Dumas, or JLD, as he is known to his fans, actually has over 1 million listeners per month. So if you break that down, it actually turns out to be about 20,000 to 30,000 views per episode. So just imagine being able to put your message out to 20 or 30,000 people at all one time. Okay, so just to make sure everyone can hear me, if you can hear me okay, hit the like button, or better yet, even let me know in the comments where you're watching from. So I'm from Champaign, Illinois, which is all about cows and cornfields. It's so funny because every time Cheryl refers to me, she says, Mary's in Chicago.
You're miles away from Chicago.
Like, but everyone thinks that if you live in Illinois and to an outsider, it's Chicago. So I'm actually about 3 hours south of Chicago. Chicago is a big city, and I live in a small-ish city. All right, so I am going to tell you what, that the reason my book became a bestseller was definitely because of the podcast. And getting on podcasts is fun. It's a joy, and it can absolutely change your life because it will explode your network like never before. So I've decided to put together a 5-day challenge, and I'll just go ahead and unveil the special announcement for the aspiring authors folks out there. So for all of you who took the aspiring authors course, we are giving you first crack because Cheryl and I are going to put together a webinar specifically for this 5-day podcasting challenge. We are only letting 10 people on the webinar, and guess what? The webinar is going to be free. So if you want to be live on the webinar, we actually already have 5 of you because it's the first 10 people who sign up for the content creation and marketing online masterclass. So for the 5 of you, so for example, Karen Kay, she's already signed up. Miriam has already signed up. Sandra has already signed up. So if you've already signed up for my content creation and marketing course, then you're already in the webinar. So we have 5 spots left. So for the first 5 people who actually attended the Aspiring Authors Online Workshop and signed up for content creation course, you will be secured the live coaching webinar for the 5-day podcast challenge. Now, and for all the rest of you, no worries. We are gonna post the replay. It's just that we're choosing 10 people that we want to be live on there with us so that we can make it super interactive and easy to learn. So let's go ahead and highlight what we're gonna do in these 5 days. So the reason I'm making it 5 days is because, guys, we need to get it done. It's not gonna be one of these things that we're gonna get done, all right? We want 5 days and we're done. You're going to book so many shows at the end of this 5 days. So what are you going to get when you sign up for the 5-day challenge, which by the way is free? So we'll give you all that information as soon as we have it available. Number one, you're going to learn on day one how to create your list. So you're going to create a list of all the shows that you are going to pitch that you want to be on. And I'm going to show you 2 different methods that I used to be able to create my list. It actually wasn't hard at all, but I did make a large, large list. Day number two of the challenge, we're actually gonna write a pitch letter. So all of you who've taken the Aspiring Authors online course or sign up for Cheryl's email list, you will get a free pitch note, and that will allow you to figure out how to write this pitch email that you're going to need to write to the shows. So we're going to be working on that on day 2 of the challenge. Now here's day 3. Day 3 is super fun. This is when we're going to be talking about our talking points. Cheryl, you want to talk a little bit about that? I know that's your area of expertise.
Yeah, so with talking points, this is really good. This is where we come into sort of key message territory. So what do you actually want to communicate when you're on the podcast itself? there are all kinds of different questions, from open questions to closed questions, but no matter what is asked, there are ways of weaving in what you want to communicate without sounding like a politician who's avoiding the question. So we'll be teaching you all the techniques there, bridging, flagging, all these weird and wonderful PR terms that will become clear on the webinar.
And that is very exciting, because on day three, we're going to be teaching you how to create a media one sheet. So for all of you in the Aspiring Authors online group, Karen Kay actually posted her beautiful one sheet. And believe it or not, she created that yesterday all by herself using the template that I sent her. So if you guys have seen her media one sheet, you will be able to create one just like the one she did, just by using the template that I will be sending you. And anyone who signs up for the 5-day challenge will get a template media sheet for absolutely free. So you don't have to sign up for any courses or do anything other than participate in the challenge, and you will be given the media one sheet. Now, that's the reason why we're going to discuss the talking points before we create the media sheet, because the talking points is something that you're going to learn how to highlight and really learn how to make your talking points sexy. We got to make it all sexy, right?
Gotta be sexy.
And then on the last day, it's just launching. You're going to launch these emails out into the world. So it's super quick. What we're going to be doing is creating a workbook for you, creating the webinar. I'm going to create the resources that you're going to need. And we will be getting this podcast challenge started very, very soon. So I hope that you are all as excited as we are. And once again, we're going to be, for the live webinar, we're going to be taking 5 more people, and it will just be the next 5 people who sign up for the content creation course. And for all of you aspiring authors, make sure that you remember that you have 4 more days, or I think maybe 3 more days now, to sign up with your discounted rate. So after that, we have settled on a price of $129 for the content creation course. Hey, Cheryl, is there anything else you want to talk about today with podcasting?
Yeah, you know what's really great about podcasting? That there's so many different advantages to it. But from a PR perspective, I've talked many times about the 3 levels of awareness. I've done this in some of our informational videos here on your page, Mary, as well as going really in-depth into it during our workshop on Sunday with the Aspiring Author Workshop. So the 3 levels of awareness are basically building your platform from 3 different levels. So first you build your own platform and build your social media. Then you move on to online media like guest blogging and podcasts. And then finally, level 3 is your mainstream media like your TV and your magazine. So what's great about podcasting is it's really moving you up those levels of influence, and therefore it's getting you more exposure. So when you do start to pitch radio and TV and what we class as that mainstream traditional media, you can say, I've already done podcasts. And that means you're already media savvy. You already have that media training, that experience, those interview techniques really honed, instead of just sort of going in cold onto a TV interview, which would be quite intimidating and not something I'd recommend as a PR gal. So podcasts are great to really help you move up those levels and help you to win even more media interviews and really practice your interview techniques too.
Yeah, and I'd like to add to that too, something really important is when you start going on your podcast journey, you're really going to go on smaller shows, and a lot of them are going to be live. So some of the other things that we're going to be covering during our webinar is like, how do you prepare for your podcast? Because one of the things I was really surprised about is how often, like, whether you're doing it through a phone or however you're doing it, I'll be showing you some of the tools I use. Like, here's the microphone. Hello, hello, hello. I love this microphone.
It's really good on that one.
Yeah, this is a Blue Yeti microphone, and it's super sensitive. Can you hear that thumpy thump?
Yeah.
I call it the thump thump. So, well, you know, I'll share with you some of the equipment that you need, but you don't even need anything, because the majority of podcasts, believe it or not, are just recorded over the telephone. So, you know, you always want to make sure it's a landline. But I'm going to talk to you about like how you build up shows, because no one is going to allow an unknown person to go on a big, huge podcast. So if you think you're going on Marie TV and hanging out with Marie Forleo, you're really kidding yourself. And also, I'm going to show you how to do this without having an agent. Mm-hmm. So I do have an agent now, and that's really wonderful. But to be honest, I've only had her for a little while, and the way that I was getting on shows was actually booking me faster than I have had using this agent. So if you have any questions about podcasting, go ahead and throw them on the comments, or if you want to know some of the shows I've been on. You know, Cheryl mentioned about platform building, and I will say that I run a large-ish Facebook group called Fearless Ambition, and the majority of people who join Fearless Ambition have either found it on Pinterest, believe it or not, or they found it on a podcast. So like if I mention the podcast on, you know, especially like a recent podcast I did was a Shameless Moms podcast. It was, you never know, like some of these things just kind of go viral. I was on a podcast called Positive Head, and I had thousands and thousands of listeners to that podcast called Positive Head. And then, but then I was on a big show recently, which is Chicken Soup for the Soul. And it actually didn't get as much listeners as the as some of the smaller ones. So you just never know which episodes are going to catch on. And also it's a great way to connect with people, because the more shows that I get on, you know, you build a relationship with these people, and then you can ask them like, what other shows can I go on? Or, you know, it's just a really great way to build yourself. Today, right before doing this Facebook Live with Cheryl, I got to give a speech. And I have to tell you that if you are on this aspiring author's journey, which I know many of us are, when you start doing podcasts, your speaking ability is going to be enhanced because you have to think quickly. So I really, to give this book talk today at this local Rotary Club that I spoke at, I really didn't have to prepare much because I've got all of this stuff in my head because I've said it so many times on a podcast. Cheryl, can you, I know you were on a recent podcast. What are some other shows you've been featured on?
Yeah, so I like to go down the writing route. So I know my audience. I know my audience are spiritual business owners and experts. There are people like psychologists and coaches and healers and light workers. And when they look for their information, they're actually not going on entrepreneurial podcasts. They're looking for writing podcasts. So I'm often on a lot of writing podcasts. The one I was on recently was the R.R. Campbell Writes Cast. And Ryan Campbell is a novelist who you'll know if you're in the fiction world. And he's a good friend of mine too. And we actually met on Twitter. And the relationships that I've gained from being friends with Ryan is absolutely amazing. I also used to run myself a sort of a mini podcast type series on YouTube, which was an author. It's called Behind the Manuscript, which I really should revive. So it was really, really fun. And I got to interview authors and have met some really great friends and made some really great friends through there. I also, for the premiere episode, asked David Morrell to be our very first guest. And I was absolutely convinced David would say, no way, I'm far too important, far too busy for that. David Morrell, of course, is the author who's been writing for 40 years now and has written 40 books and comic books and countless essays. He used to be a prof of English. And David Morrell wrote First Blood, which became the Rambo movies. So he actually invented Rambo. So he's produced his books into screenplays. Anyway, so I interviewed him and we built a really great friendship, and he offered to mentor me through writing fiction. So to have an award-winning novelist who wrote Rambo, who's been writing for 40 years, to talk to me about his novel at the time, which is about Victorian history, which I love being a Brit, to build that friendship and to build that relationship, you cannot buy that. I would not have found that opportunity anywhere else. So just as Mary says, the value of doing this, it's not just the PR side, which of course that's what I do and I love, but it's the relationships you're building. You never know when you'll need to call on that person and ask for maybe a bit of help with your book. You know, will they be able to write your foreword in your book, or be able to write a review of your manuscript, or help you out finding a publisher, an agent? Honestly, I could go on and on about it. I mean, it's so valuable. The relationships you build are just amazing.
It's so true. And thank you so much, Cheryl. I actually just noticed that I don't know if Brandon Beecham from Positive Head is watching, but he actually hit the like button. So I think it's so cool that I mentioned his show, and he may or may not be watching this broadcast. But
Must have felt the energy picked up on it.
He might have. I actually had such an amazing time on that show. So being on a podcast is fun. It's not scary at all. And it's a great way to build your platform, especially if you don't have one. And for all of your aspiring authors, you know, I know we are working on writing our proposals right now, but the thing is, that's the best time to go on your show. The first show I went on, I was actually still only writing maybe chapter 4 or chapter 6 of the book. And I was terrified to go on the show because, I don't know, in my head, I created a belief that I needed to have already completed my book or else I wouldn't have anything to talk about. And that was absolutely absurd because the truth is, on the earlier shows that I went to, I was actually trying to get through too much. And so it was when I learned how to relax a little bit and understand, like, I didn't have to recite my entire book to these people on a podcast. Life got a lot smoother. So again, we're going to be enrolling in a 5-day challenge. It's going to be really fun. Cheryl and I are actually just having our first meeting about this Sunday. So we're going to get everything mapped out for you guys. But basically, it's a 5-day challenge. So day one, you're going to be writing a list. Day two, you're going to write your pitch letter. Day three, you're going to create your interview topics. Day four, we're going to create a media one sheet, which is valuable. And I'll even show you like the early versions of mine compared to the more recent versions so that you can see how it evolved. Because when I first started doing this, I actually had a 9-page media kit. And it was way too much information for someone to look at and make a decision quickly whether or not they wanted me to be on their show. And I'll give you tips and tricks along the way, like the secrets of being a really good guest and someone that you know, you want your host to actually want you back on the show. That's like a big honor when someone says, I really want you to come back on the show. So on the last day, after we've got all the preparatory work done, you're going to hit send on those emails, guys. It's going to be a big moment. We will have a little celebration to send out those emails. And I'm going to create a bundle, a workbook for you guys to be able to have everything you need to get through these 5 days. So if you're interested in our 5-day challenge, you know, definitely drop us a note below and we will be in touch or reach out and send one of us a message. Anything to add, Cheryl?
Yeah, I think just to make things really clear for people, so the 5-day challenge we're running is free, but it's the webinar, the live webinar where we're only taking 10 people. And that is really a bonus for our content workshop, which is $129. So just to be really clear about the 5-day challenge is free. And if you want to be on the webinar, that's when you can choose to join if you want to. So come and join us for the 5-day webinar, the 5-day podcast challenge. There's going to be loads and loads of value there. And we're really, really excited to teach you.
That's awesome. I see, is it Emmeline Jackson? She's very interested in the challenge, and we will be happy.
Hey, Emmeline. Go ahead.
Do you know, is that a UK name? Do you know her?
Emmeline's in my group. Yeah, I have a group called the Heart Hub, which is a promotion-friendly entrepreneur group, and Emmeline's in it. Yeah.
Did you guys all hear that? A promotion-friendly heart group called what?
It's called the Heart Hub. So I'll pop the link down below, perhaps. But it's promotion friendly. If you're an entrepreneur or a light worker, come on in, and we've got some really amazing people in there.
Yeah, and it's always nice to know, like, especially if you're in a Facebook group, you know, which ones you can promote in and which ones you can't. So that's awesome. Emmeline, we will be so excited for you to be joining us. And Emmeline says hello to you, Cheryl. So also, you know, we've already got our first 5 signups for people that are going to be on this webinar who've also signed up for the content creation and marketing course. So I'm very excited to get everything underway. So of course, Cheryl and I will be back talking about the podcast challenge probably quite often. And I think very soon we're going to pop live into the Aspiring Authors group and answer some writing questions because everyone loves to write. So, okay, is that it for now, Cheryl? Any parting words from you?
Yeah, you just triggered a bit of a memory, something I was going to say earlier. So with the Aspiring Authors group, they've gotten so much more than just the workshop. They're really being privy right now to basically pre-sale before the tickets went on sale for the content workshop. They were having the chance to purchase them. So there's all kinds of really fun bonuses we throw in when you join one of our workshops. So once you become one of our alumni, you do have access to sort of our inner circle for a certain period of time, and you get all kinds of juicy bonuses. So don't miss out.
Yeah, that's a really good point. And I, you know, the thing that has struck me is, you know, we only did that class on Sunday, and the amount of stuff people have gotten done, I'm just like, whoa. And the amount of inspiration and motivation they have has just like, it has, I wasn't expecting that, because, you know, talking about proposal writing and book writing, it can be dense, very clinical type of content. Mm-hmm. And we just sent out the replay for that last night. So we hope that you guys all watch it a second time and a third time. And we will have that available for sale as well very soon. So thank you for your time today, Cheryl. And we will be at it again very soon. See you later.
Bye, everyone.
Hey, this is Mary. Thanks so much for watching. Check out a free chapter of my book, Conscious Communications, at maryshores.com/free chapter. The link is in the description below.